The developing embryo in situ is small and fragile. Contrast is low because the tissues are transparent and only the blood flowing in the arteries and veins provides some color. Big features of the embryo are visible though. The head with the eye cup. Pigment of the retina is formed early. The tail, partially hidden by the lower extremity. The early allantois, the forelimb. And finally, the heart, which is still linear at this stage. It includes a sinus venosus, an atrium, a ventricle, and a truncus arteriosus. Blood flows into the dorsal aorta and then over the yolk sac. Blood returns to the heart via the cardinal veins that drain into the sinus venosus. In order to study the details, we took a 72-hour embryo, digitized it, and removed the yolk. Now we can rotate, we can manipulate, and by changing density, study details inside the embryo. A feature typical for embryos is segmentation. Inside the embryo, one can see a series of somites that are even better visible after virtual slicing. After further reducing density, more details become visible. Of course, individual sections provide the best detail. So let's run through an entire series of sections. The arrows indicate the notochord. We have 3D reconstructed a notochord, which is an essential organizing center. And this is the 3D movie. The notochord induces the neural tube, so notochord and neural tube are closely related. By further reducing density in our 3D reconstructions, we can isolate the neural tube and the brain. Note the early eye cups, the future retina, that form out of the brain. From an ectodermal placode, the otic vesicle develops, that in turn will form the inner ear. Now here's a 3D reconstruction showing both the neural tube and the notochord. By combining the 3D reconstruction and the virtual slices, we can determine the exact position of nearly every organ in the developing embryo. The body of the embryo shows a 90-degree torque. The tail of the embryo is still positioned flat on the yolk, while the upper part of the body is lying on its side. The heart is very close to the head. The otic vesicle is getting very close to the first pharyngeal slit. This slit will later form the external acoustic meatus. A conspicuous structure is Grotthus pouch. The pituitary gland forms out of this pouch and the infundibular recess of the third ventricle. Finally, note that in this very early embryo, already cranial nerves are developing.